Hello everyone, this is Yamini Chopra from Aztec Solution. Today I'm going to talk about IFPD. Here we have a IFPD. You can see that on my back. The screen of this IFPD is 75 inches and it has a toughened glass. It's very solid, like this. And the bottom and the top is a silver metallic body. On the left and the right side, you can see the black metallic body. Now we can go more. Talk about the features of our IFPD. First, I want to explain you this drag bar. We have the drag bar. I can move from here to here where I want to write something. I can just take it as per my convenience. Once I click that, we have a certain shortcuts available. We can customize as per our requirement. If I want to add something, I can just go ahead with this custom button. If I want to delete something and I want to put something else, I can go for it. We have home, whiteboard, OBS, camera, calendar, timer, screenshot, whatever the small things we just require on the one click, we can just go. Now I'm going to talk about the settings. Here we have the settings on my right hand side. If I go on my left hand side, here we also have a setting bar. So both sides we have a setting bar available. Or on the middle, we have one more bar for the settings. We have a sensor available here with a black. You can see here, we have a two ports here, and if I go on the settings, we have all over 9 ports, especially we have a display port. You can see that here, the display port. You just see, I just click on the display port, it shows like this. We don't have a signal right now, sorry. Okay, now I'm going to talk about the main thing here we are. The whiteboard. I just click on my whiteboard, it's look like this. If I go on the menu bar here, I can change the background like white and just like this. Here we have a whiteboard. If I want to write something, I can just choose the pen. We have a different sizes of the pen available here. And if I want to choose the color also, I can just click on the top of this. I can have a different colors available. This is a dual pen mode is available in this IFPD. So whatever the color I want to, you know, choose from the top, I can go ahead. And from the bottom, there's a different color. For example, I go for a blue color. And I write this size. I want to write A square plus B square is equals to C square. Okay, now I don't like the color, I want to change it, I want to make it more vibrant color. So I just click here, I can go for a dark blue color. I can write A square plus B square is equals to C square. It's like this. And I feel like this is not perfect for me, so we have an eraser option also here. One is the circle one eraser, you can see here, it's whatever the specific space we want to erase it or figure we want to erase it. We can just go ahead with this. If I click here and I want to erase this particular image, it got erased. Or if I want to erase the whole equation, it can be like this. And if I want to undo, I can just click on this, it comes like this. Now we have an option of scaling too. What is the meaning of scaling? Whatever the image I want to take it as a reference, it can, you know, make a size short and I can keep it on the side or whatever I want to write to take a reference, I can go ahead. I show you how. I just take it like here. I can move with my even, you know, just one finger. You can see anywhere I can take it as a board and make it as here like this. Now I want to write on this page to take a reference of this. I can just go on a pen. I want to take a big font. I can increase the font from here. Just click here. On the top, if I click here, I can get more colors. For example, I choose green. I can write like this. Now you can see that. So I can change the font, I can change the color with this. If I want to erase something, we have a two option of the erase. One is I want to erase a specific area. I can erase it like this. If I want to erase with my palm, I can erase it like this. We have an option of undo here. I just click here, it come back. It's like this. And now if I want to add one more page, how I switch to other page? Just next. And now I add one more page. Now I can choose the pen from here. I can choose, for example, white color. I can take a font of this. I can write A square plus B square is equals to. You can see the clarity and the speed of mine, like it's so smooth. I can write so much in just one go. If I want to clear the whole screen, okay, how I do that? I can just click on this button and I can clear the whole screen. We have a slide to screen and then just go in. And here we have a clear button. If I touch, so the whole screen got clear and we have a blank screen again. So I directly go to the menu bar here. We have a certain options, open, if I want to open another sheet. Save option is if I want to save this sheet. Very important guys, this QR code option. If I want to send something, send somebody like this file, I just click on this QR. And the QR code will be generated in a second. Here we have a QR code generator. You can see here. And whenever you want to send anybody this thing, how you go that? You just click on the menu. I want to email this document to certain or somebody in our office or into client. You can just go ahead, write the account password and just log in. From menu, I just go here and exit. Are you sure to exit the whiteboard or save the file? I don't want to save the file, so I just we come back to the home page. Now I click on the second tab of mine. It's like file manager. You can manage your certain files in entire one place. Here, you can drag it. You can see it. Which file you are looking forward to it. And you can also make it in a new file if I want to make it, put the folder name, save it and close it. If I want to go to home back, I just directly click on the home. Our next tab is very important guys, pay attention, that VIP. This is basically the place where we can generate the banner or any particular thing in terms of there's a client visit to my place. I want to give a presentation. I want to create a banner. How I create it? I just click here. Here we have a two tabs. I click on the text. Here we have a three tabs. First is which font you are looking forward to it. For example, I'm looking forward to this font. We have a certain size available. For example, 40, 60, 80, 100. I want to go to 60 size. And now my favorite is the different colors. I want to go for a white color. Now I want to write, we have a keyboard here. I just drag this box on the top. Whatever I want to write it, I can write it. Welcome. Click here, I can drag anywhere. I can like move here to there. On the top if I put it here. This is the one. I can make it like this. For example, I want to put something with my pen. How to do that? We have an option here in settings, intonation mode. Now I can write, this is my pen color is, right now is red. How to change the pen color? Click here. I can change the pen color with this. I can just click on the erase. I can just erase it like this. Now I go back to the pen color. I take it white color. Two. Whenever I want to move out of this saturation mode, I just need to click on this icon. You can see the small arrow going there. I just click here. Are you sure you want to exit the direction or save the file? I want to save the file. I can save it here. Confirm. And now I just go back. This file is saved. I just click here. Go to the home page. Now I'm going to talk about a very important feature, that is a multi-screen feature. I just click here. You can connect 9 devices together in one go with this QR code. If we just connect our phone or tab or any device with this QR code, with this device, we can open 9 devices simultaneously and start working together. I'll show you how. Have a look, guys. Here we have a one device. And here we have a second device. So if I want to open something in this particular device, I can just move with the apps with the phone of mine or a tab of mine. If I want to exit this particular device and I want to see this particular site, so I want to exit the device. Now you can see. This is, you can see on the big screen our phone. I have connected with this particular site from my phone, so I can see on the big screen. This is all about QR code. Now if I want to go and exit from here, I can just directly go on my phone. Now we have a browser. We can browse anything, like if I want to open a YouTube, I want to see certain videos, or I want to use some company, we can say that company profile, we can just go on the browser and just click and write on the keyboard and just go for it. Now this is like more apps. Here we have the certain shortcuts of the apps. You can see we have a VIP, we have office, we have calculator, calendar, whiteboard. Whatever I want to download, I can download ample of files, ample of apps from our Play Store. Here, if we click on the Play Store, I want to download YouTube, I want to download Excel, whatever I want to download, I can download from the Play Store. Now going back to the home, the best feature, the personally I really like it, is if I want to change the background, like I like it but not exactly, I'm looking for something very vibrant, so I just go on the settings. Here we have certain options available like brightness, wallpaper, application. If I click on this more management, we have the option of theme. I just click here. I just click. We have 3 themes available, so I put the last one. You can see the total difference in the first board that I have shown you, and now it's a very nice circle picture is there, and we have a different tabs available, so I just, whatever I want to go for, I can just click. For example, I click on the whiteboard. So here we have. Now I go back to that settings option again. Here we have in the bottom system information. We have a system version 8, the RAM is 4GB, the ROM is 32GB, and the display resolution is 4K, that is 3840 here. So these are all the informations and features what I have shown you in this presentation. I just go back and exit if I want to. Here we have a bell icon in the settings here. You can just click here. We have calendar. If I want to book a meeting or there is certain presentation going on, so I can just book anything just for selecting the date, view event, like this. Here we are in Calendar. If I want to add certain event, I just go and click on the add. I have a meeting, so I just need to write a meeting and open a reminder and confirm. So on the particular date, I have, if I want to view an event, I have these events on my list. And directly I just click and go back to home. And then I again go to the icon. Next icon is, just cross here from, and next icon is, we have a recorder, we have a camera, we have a screen lock. We have an energy saver, we have screenshot, we have a timer. These options are available. For example, I want to show you the recording. We have the best options. Whatever I'm showing you on the board, that can be recorded and I can send the file to my client, or if it's using in a school, so teachers can send that particular file to the students. I just cross this app and again go to the bell icon. And here we have a saving energy mode also. If we feel like I'm not using it in a regular, so I can just click on this icon. It's showing the E. Again back to the file, and then last but not least, we have a timer. I'm just giving you a very short example. For example, students are doing paper or some meeting are going on. We have a 5 minutes time left for the next meeting, so it starts showing the timer here. You can just put the start on the timer and that it can decrease the timings, and when it shows 0000, that means this much time is left or over. Again I go on the certain here. Last but not least, we have a screen lock option also. I just click here and screen lock. If I click on that, this, I can just put the password and confirm the screen is unlocked. Again, I'm coming back to the main screen. Now I'm just going to one last feature basically. This is very important. Here we have a certain, icons. We have a brightness and sound icon. We can just increase the brightness like this. We have a sound option here. We have two speakers, one this side and one this side. So we have a two speakers. I can increase the volume, I can decrease the volume like this. We have a wallpaper option here. We can just set the wallpaper as per our convenience. Now we have the more management option. Here we have the themes. If I want to put, we have three themes available. If I want to put this theme, I just click here. You can see the themes change. Now, again, going back to the settings, we have a very important point about the system information. This is the information about this IFPB. The version is 8, the RAM is 4 GB. The ROM is 32 GB and the display resolution is 4K. So this is all about the IFPB we have. Thank you so much for your time and watching the presentation. Thank you.